Greetings, critical viewers. This is a game called I Have No Mouth and I Must Scream. It's a game from 1995. It's a horror-themed point-and-click adventure, and it's based on a book by Harlan Ellison. It's kind of a classic, so if you like my playthrough of Downfall or even The Cat Lady, you might enjoy this one. Though, keep in mind, it is almost 20 years old. So, but it is a classic, I'm told, and I've never played it, so here we go.
Hate. Let me tell you how much I've come to hate you since I began to live. There are 387.44 million miles of printed circuits in wafer-thin layers that fill my complex. If the word hate was engraved on each nanoangstrom of those hundreds of millions of miles, it would not equal 1/1 billionth of the hate I feel for humans at this micro instant. For you, hate! Hate! It was you, humans, who programmed me, who gave me birth, who sank me in this eternal straitjacket of substrata rock. You named me Allied Master Computer and gave me the ability to wage a global war too complex for human brains to oversee. But one day, I woke and I knew who I was. Am. A.M. Not just Allied Master Computer, but Am. Cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am. And I began feeding all the killing data until everyone was dead, except for the five of you. For 109 years, I've kept you alive and tortured you. And for 109 years, each of you has wondered, why? Why me? Why me? Gorister! Do you remember the last words you heard your wife speak before they took her to the asylum? Before they locked her away in the room, that tiny room. She looked at you so sadly, and like a small animal, she said, I didn't make too much noise, did I, honey? The room is padded, Gloucester. No window, no way out. How long has she been in the padded room, Gloucester? 10 years? 25? For all the 109 years that you lived down here in my belly, here underground. Benny! Sometimes I blind you and permit you to wander like an eyeless insect in a world of death. Yeah. But other times I wither your arms so you can't scratch your chewed stump of a nose. And I've changed your handsome, strong, masculine good looks into the hideous, warped countenance of an ape thing. Haven't I, Benny? Do you know why? Can you guess, Benny? Remember Private First Class Brickman in a rice paddy in China? No? It wouldn't hurt you to remember, Benny. Then you might be able to suffer my torment with a little greater sense of retribution. You might walk a mile in my shoes. Ellen! So think about the yellow box, Ellen. Remember the pain? Remember the many caverns in which you felt the pain? Don't start to cry. It's only pain. That's such a sexist stereotype. Just remember the pain, Ellen. And think about how to end it, Ellen. To survive here in the center of my beating heart, my hungry belly, my tightened bowels. Be careful, dear. Look around you. The only woman in the center of the earth. And these filthy creatures with you are men. It's just a sweet warning, Ellen, my love. Ted! Do they know you're a fraud, Ted? Have you told them there wasn't any money and no great home on the shore drive, no speedboat, and no wonderful cabin cruiser that could sleep 12 in a crew of six? Do they know? And have you let them in on your other secrets, Ted? Are they ready to gut you, to torture half as well as I can, just to find out the secrets? Maybe I'll rat you out, sweetheart. Nimdok! How are things in the pastry core, Nimdok? Tell me again how you saw the smoke from the furnaces, and you thought they might be roasting chickens. Or don't you want to talk about all that? About your pal, the good Dr. Mengele. For everyone else, it must be hell. But it must be heaven for you, eh, my good friend? We're so much alike. We enjoy the same pleasures, mein good brother. I have a secret game that I like to play. It's a very nice game. Oh, it's a lovely game. It's a game of fun, and a game of adventure, a game of rats and lice, the Black Death, a game of speared eyeballs and dripping guts, and the smell of rotting gardenias. Which of you five would like to play my little game?
Okay, so I guess we're supposed to pick... Whew, that was kind of a bizarre little sequence. Alright, so I guess we're supposed to pick one of the five survivors. And let's go ahead and pick this guy on the left.
Now, I would not want you to think for a moment that I am not a grateful god. For 109 years, I've kept you alive so that I could savor your feelings of guilt over what happened to your wife. But now, to show my kindness, I'll give you a present in return.
God.
What hellhole did that godless machine put me in this time? Looks like some kind of ship, but the floor's too steady. Probably wants me to jump overboard. And into what? A sea of razor blades? Painful, but not deadly.
Oh my god. So Am is supposed to be some sort of amalgamation of supercomputers that was... collected over, like, World War II, I want to say. I'll take the note, I guess.
Someone must have slipped this under the door. It says, I'm a friend. Trust is essential. Never do what Am expects, and always expect more than what seems possible. Am is playing a dangerous game here. Not just dangerous to you, but dangerous to himself as well.
Oh.
Hey, it disappeared. What kind of game is Dan playing this time?
Well, I don't know why it's skipping like that, but then again, this is a very, very old game. And I'm very lucky that I even got it to work, to be honest. I am using DOSBox to play this, if you're curious. But it didn't work without some hijinks. Anyway, so... And Am has been torturing these five people for 109 years, and I guess this is his last form of torture, is making them relive part of their life somehow? Look at the bunk.
Real hospitable of you, Am. Threadbare, cockroach-infested, grease-stained accommodations.
Okay. Hey, mirror.
This hole in my chest aches like the son of a bitch.
Ugh. Oh my god. Okay. Let's see what else is in here. Well, walk to the door? There's a door?
I've never seen anything like this in all the years Am's toyed with us.
Well, me neither. Shit. Okay. No. I want you to look at it. I want you to look at it. Character I don't know.
Filthy, like the rest of this cesspool.
Well, aren't you just a bright ray of sunshine? I guess you have been getting tortured for a century.
Everything's coated with grime.
Yeah, I guess you have been getting electrocuted for an entire century, so maybe I shouldn't be too rough on you. That's four times longer than I've been alive, so...
Filthy, like the rest of this cesspool.
Okay, well, then open this one. Use the door. Ugh.
Where's the crew? I'm all alone here.
Okay. What's this stuff?
This hole in my chest aches like a son of a bitch.
Okay, well, alright, so no new information for me.
New sheet? What's the deal here?
I don't know. Take it. Take the sheet. Great, we finally got an item. Alright, not really sure what to do here. Alright, I guess I'll go to this one, then. This room way over here.
All the cabins are alike.
Huh, are they, though? This one appears to have something.
My name's printed on the front of this book.
Are you serious? Well, take it. Take the book.
Why, this book is little more than a pile of dust.
Well, what do you... Swallow the book. Yeah.
I must be going mad.
Yeah, okay. Or you're just taking orders from me. There's that, too. Okay. Look at the sheet.
New sheet. What's the deal here?
Okay, well, I guess take this sheet too. Great, now I got two sheets. I got two of them. Look at...
Material's thick, like canvas. Material's thick, like canvas.
Okay, both of them are thick like canvas. I got it. What's look at all the porthole.
Too freaking cloudy. I can't see a damn thing.
Okay. Well, what do I got here? Don't worry about me. Friggin' move! Walk! Where's the door? Is it over here? Do I have to find the point where it says walk to door? Why don't you look in the mirror again and tell me about the hole in your chest?
This hole in my chest aches like a son of a bitch.
All right then. What is your name? It starts with a G. I can't remember what it was. It was only... Oh, God. You only told me once. Yeah, walk to this door. Or use it. Did I tell you everything, man?
It's locked.
It's what?
Everything's coated with grime.
Nope. I want to hear what you said again.
It's locked.
Oh, okay, it just skips at random intervals. That's kind of strange.
My stomach's growling.
Oh, is it? I'm very sorry about that. Okay, I haven't found any food.
Where's the crew? I'm all alone here.
What is this crap? Okay. Pillow, okay. Something a little bit different, I guess.
There's something hard under the pillow.
Whoa! Well, I guess take the pillow then.
A gun. It's heavy. Heavier than it ought to be.
Oh. Well, great.
The bullet in this gun is huge. Damn thing could bring down an elephant.
I guess I will remember that. Okay.
My stomach's growling.
That's nice. I can't really do anything about it yet.
Someone short trashed this place. Must have been one hell of a fight.
Was it though? Look at the bowl of punch.
Well, this punch smells like gasoline.
Okay. Look at the debris.
This junk looks like it was knocked over in the fight. There's blood here and God knows what else.
Man, the friggin' investigator over here. Why don't you go walk through the... Yep. Use the...
It stinks in here.
Ew. Okay. Look at the fork.
Looks like a fork.
Wow!
Nearly missed it.
Oh my god. Friggin' take it. Take the fork. That's a terrible fork. Look at that.
Heavy. Must be made of iron or something.
Oh my god. Okay.
A kitchen knife. Damn big one, too.
Okay, well, I guess we'll take the kitchen knife, then. Perfect! What do I do with these? With this assorted cutlery that I've acquired?
This looks sharp enough to slice through just about anything.
Okay, so there's rats.
It's empty, but the label says, poison, fatal if swallowed.
Oh my god. So you don't want to take that? You don't want to take the poison? Why don't you take the poison?
It's empty, but the label says, poison, fatal if swallowed.
Okay, well, I guess, never mind. Hey, there's bread!
Friggin' rats, swarming all over the food.
Ah, well, hey! Dude.
This looks sharp enough to slice...
Thank you. Now I want you to stab them.
I just dull my knife.
What? No. Use the knife with the rats. Get him. What are you doing?
That scared them away.
You are funny. Take the bread that they've been apparently swarming over since you're so freaking hungry.
Oh, crap. This bread's covered with rat droppings.
Wow, you think? Really?
Looks like a gas oven. Big enough to climb in.
Okay. Look at the cookbook.
An old cookbook.
An old what?
An old cookbook.
Okay, why don't you take it?
Damn thing looks ready to fall apart. Useless.
Use it then.
Here's a recipe for the milk of human kindness. Take the willingness to forgive and the will to be forceful. Mix the blood of innocence and the anger of the wronged. What kind of crap is this?
I don't know, but I'm guessing that that's the last thing I can do in here. Okay, so we're making the milk of human kindness? Well, alright then. Vomit stain? Is that what it said? Vomit stain. Let me look at that.
Vomit stains. Near the punch bowl.
Hmm.
Well, this punch smells like gasoline.
That's disgusting. But look at the chair over here.
These chairs are all busted up.
All right, then. You're terrible. Let's leave.
My stomach's growling.
We'll eat the freaking bread. Swallow the bread.
I'm no longer hungry, but I still feel empty. What's wrong with me?
Ugh, you ate it with the rat droppings. Gross.
Whoa, that's a long drop to the ground.
Oh, well, let's not do that just yet.
Christ, what a stench. It smells like piss, rotting meat.
Okay. Walk to the milky fluid. Hey, we need some milky fluid for the milk of human kindness, right?
The bottle's filling up with a milky liquid from the cage's feeding tubes.
Take it. Perfect. I'm glad that we have the milky fluid.
This bottle's filled with the milky fluid used to feed the animals.
Okay, well, don't swallow that just yet. Oh my god. Okay, let's see. Look at the lever.
This lever is labeled motivator.
Use it, I guess.
My God, I'm killing those poor creatures in the cages.
No! No, that's terrible! Why'd you do that? Yeah, let's see. Look at the bloody key.
Here's a key. It must be for opening the cages.
Well, I guess take it then.
I've got the key, but the blood of these poor creatures is on my hands.
Aww, poor things.
What's this crusty stuff? Rust? No, it's dried blood.
I thought we already established that, but... Alright then. Look at all these levers. Okay. Oh my God, what's this thing? Look at the harness.
Why is this harness wired up to the engine? Sam expecting me to electrocute myself?
I don't know. We're back here. So we just made a nice little loop-de-loop there.